And the next speaker is Mr. Haldun Azhari. He's a bureau chief of Pan-Orient News. He's originally from Syria and he's stationed in Tokyo and covering the current affairs in Tokyo. So maybe he has many examples to cover the issues from the Arab or Islamic perspectives. Please.
Thank you. Pan-Orient News is my own company, actually, and I established it to cover Japan and East Asia, but now we are focusing on Japan. And it's registered in the Japanese government and authorities. So I think it's the only Arabic media now registered in Japan. And this company represents many Arabic and Islamic media, mostly from like Jordan, United Arab Emirates, and Egypt and Iran, and sometimes other countries. So we are trying to expand here, despite the very difficult financial situation and, I mean, expenses, high cost in Japan. But generally, we have very good support from our Japanese colleagues in the media and also from the Japanese authorities, especially the foreign ministry and the justice ministry. They always really give very nice and good attention to the media from the Islamic and the Arabic countries. We feel sometimes we are special, so that's why we try to take advantage of that. But basically, we have a lot of competition here, and the running an office is very difficult. That's why my office is in Kyoto News Building, and Kyoto supports me tremendously. So we appreciate always the Japanese media support of its partners, Arabic media. If I go back to the main logo, main theme of our conference, it's about bridging the gap, or trying to build the bridges between Arabic and or Islamic media and Japan. I'm not sure much about the Islamic media because there are many Islamic countries in the world, like Indonesia or Malaysia. I'm sorry, I don't know much about how the media there represented in Japan or report about Japan. But I can talk about Arabic and Iranian media here because I present many of these organizations. Generally, the reports about Japan are very extensive and increasing because the attention is going toward the East more than the West, especially in recent years. And Japan provides a great opportunity for not news only about Japan, but for about technology, economy, and American bases in Japan are an important source of news because we know the American military here has a lot of operation in the Islamic and Arabic countries, and people want to know what's going on here in Japan because any news about the American military here might affect the situation in the Middle East. So the attention about Japan is seriously increasing, and I see a lot of more media interested in covering Japanese news. At the same time, when I check Japanese news, news about Japan in Arabic media, it's mostly copy and paste, or translate, copy, paste, mostly from Reuters, Reuters AP and Agence France Presse. They are providing great, you know, deal of news about Japan, but they're still, they are Western. The way they think is different from the Arabic way of thinking. So, for example, if you cover the issue of Yasukuni Shrine in Japan, you rarely see in the Arabic media explanation on how the Japanese really feel about Yasukuni. So one time I made a report about Yasukuni and I interviewed many people in that shrine, including the Oyaku, or the right-wingers, and they told me why they support Yasukuni. That was a great opportunity to explain what's the real Yasukuni issue in Japanese society. But if you read mostly Western media reports about Yasukuni, you just read the Chinese criticism. China criticized Japan, China is angry about Yasukuni. So we try to report what's going on in Japan from maybe Arabic point of view. So I think increasing Arabic presence in Japan would help a lot to bridge this gap. The other point I mentioned in my paper is maybe one sample about the so-called terrorism. It's really serious issue because once you say Islamist or whatever you want to say, Islamic terrorism, Muslim terrorist, whatever, I'm personally and my agency against using the word Islam, no matter what is the terrorism issue is. If there is terrorism, you say this is terrorism. If the people are committed this terrorist, as a media, I never mention they are Muslims or Buddhists or Christians. I think if all religions are, if you say this is Islam or this is Buddhism or this is Christianity, it's impossible that this religion is calling for terrorism. So the media, especially the editorial department, should prevent anybody to write the word Islamic terrorism or Muslim terrorist or whatever Islam related in this issue, because that when the normal people in the street or girls high school, they read Muslim terrorist or Muslim fundamentalist, whatever, they really feel afraid when they see some people who look like certain characters promoted in the media. So I think there is great responsibility on in the Arabic media also. We tend to say the so-called terrorism, the war on the so-called terrorism, because we don't recognize it as really terrorism. The issue is very complicated. So I think one major role for the media to play is to be careful about linking Islam with any committed or crimes or attacks or similar acts. I think there are many more issues to discuss. Perhaps that would be in the Q&A session. Thank you for attention.